And here we go for our first match tonight. We have Shipezu versus Smimo. Smimo going with the Mario. That's an interesting one. With the Waluigi color alt. Respect. Meanwhile, Shipezu seemingly sticking with their tried and true Corrin. So, sorry, I just got a bit delayed, but anyways. Show on the road. Let's see if Smymo has what it takes to make that Mario count. He's definitely not as easy to play as Incineroar. At least on paper. Maybe to succeed with is easier than Incineroar. So far, Smymo putting in work. Getting a nice lead, but there it goes. One combo, and it is gone. And that is... Okay, still makes it back. What a recovery. Yeah, just trying to catch him dropping shield, and that should have been a better punish. Okay, there we go. Not able to convert off of it. Still catches him with that up air. Yeah. And that is going to be the first stock of this game. Getting a little too eager with that forward smash and coming back to bite him. Ooh, found an up air, but wasn't ready to follow up on it. Was too deep in the side before a follow-up. And that was an interesting... Looks like they got the sweet spot that pushed him away. That sweet spot can be scary, especially as a two-frame. There we go. Knocks, still not enough. Yep, what's it gonna take for Smymo to take a stock here? Oof, just... Oh boy, eats a big punish for that up smash. Good avoidance of the back air at least. So not losing the second stock just yet. Ooh, boy, that almost did it. Oof, nearly getting the punish, just barely missing, and just badly wants that up smash, which is understandable. It's almost certainly going to take the stock, but when you get too predictable with it, the opponent is going to recognize it and punish you harshly. That's the downside of risking, well... Finally finds an up smash after five plus tries. Might be 10. Still looks like Shaipsu is in firm control of this game. And just smacking him around. There's a punish on the side B at least. Yeah, you have to respect that up air. It is huge! Drop the combo or this. Guess the DI, not able to quite finish out the stock. There's an okay punish at least. Back air gonna be met with a parry up air, and that, yep, that will do it. Shaipsu taking game one in convincing fashion. Yoshi's Story. Okay, looking for the triplats, one of Mario's favorite things on a stage. I haven't seen too many ladder combos from Smymo, though, so I'm not sure just how well he's going to be able to utilize it. Shaipsu still seems to have his number. Ooh, there he goes. That up air is up tilt is not the ladder combo and combo monster it was in Smash 4, people. Similar to last game, starting out even, we'll see if it stays that way. So it was eventually where Shaipsu just was starting to get every read on Smymo and took it from there. Good jump to escape that forward smash. Ooh, decent punish on the down air. Nothing too special, but it's something. Who's going to take the first stock here? Good attempt, but just air dodged at the right time to avoid it. That should be the stock. No, just barely not gonna do it. respect the attempt to control the stage, and that, however, still not enough. Bit frustrating to still be alive. Okay, there we go. Nice side B punish with that back air. Just barely mistimed it. Otherwise, that would have easily been it. Yeah, you have to be so careful. We've got to respect that up air because it could eats the sweet spot forward smash for this first stock. So no percentage lead going into the next one. Shaipzu is quickly taking the percentage lead himself. Just catching Smimo doing everything. Needs to really make this combo count. Ooh, dropped the combo. Not sure how much extension you could get at that percent, though. Good punish on it, and there's a good nair to keep him off stage. Was looking for great punish. There we go. That's an okay ladder combo. And nice and classic trap. Up the sending him flying, and ow, that does it. Yeah, Smimo not looking too happy to get hit by that one. Badly wanted a forward smash, just did not find it too far away. I think he might have been looking for a back air trap. Either he didn't commit or it was just too slow to work. Oof. Pretty suboptimal punish on that side B. Still not going to survive. Yep, gonna survive that one. That's gonna put him in an awkward spot. Okay, good choice of cancel to go high, now putting Smimo in disadvantage again. Oh. Okay, I gotta go play. Be back. Yeah.
battle. Thomas. Elba.
It's like Smimo going back to the Incineroar and Prince HD not messing around, going straight to the Steve. Honestly, I don't know how this one will go. Because Prince HD seems a little rusty, but I mean, that's... Mimo's Incineroar can put in work. Doesn't look like he's gonna get much of a chance here, though. Oof, running right into that TNT and gonna cost him the stock. Nice back air. Oof. There we go! That is some nice reads! Odd that he went for the up throw variant, though, and gets a little greedy on the grab mash. That should do it! Nope! Gets the sour spot. That feels like it should have been the stunt. Oh, I gotta go. Bye!
General Steve! Lucario. Torrid.
Yeah, it's been a while since I've seen Yo-Yo Guy. Lucario is a character I remember him playing. And unfortunately, there's a reason you don't see more Lucarios. Because, yeah, when he gets to those hypersense, he's terrifying! Ganondorf look weak by comparison, but the problem is, living to those percents, against a really good opponent, they aren't going to let you get to that percent very often, and that's our fundamental problem that Lucario runs into. See if this one goes differently. It was pretty close, and definitely had him in that scary spot where you need to finish him off before the aura can do anything too devastating. Yep, I gotta go play again.
Yeah.
Huh. Oh dear, looks like the stream has broken. Yep, sorry folks, sometimes Elgato be like that. So once I can, I'll go fix stream and then and then get the score. And we are back. I'm already out of the tournament. Had Ant and Greed on my back-to-back. That's a rough bracket. So what you gonna do? And Kofu going with the Mii Brawler this time. And the 2-0 deficit doesn't seem to be working out too well for him. Oh boy. There's the accelerado. Ooh, nice spot dodge. Just not able to... Yeah, that could have been a better, bigger punish, because that thing is super unsafe on if it whiffs. Yep, keeping up that pressure. That side B is strong, people, and got the fully charged neutral B, not quite enough to take the stock from the middle of the stage, it would seem. At least at that percent. Just barely missing. They're just... Oh, and there we go. Finally finding their hit with a devastating forward smash. You do not want to get hit by that thing. It is so strong, but in exchange, it is very, very punishable. It's the classic high-risk, high-reward move. Oof, and there's a good back air to take that first stock at least. Catches him with a grab to stall out some of that. Ooh, good attempt, did not find its mark. Good call out on the fire kick at least. So not and zoom, giving him a very safe one, but just barely missing, but finds another. Not quite enough to take the stock from the bottom of the stage. Another zoom, another safe recovery. Oof. There's a good... Not going to find its mark this time. Just going for as much damage as he can there and doesn't backfire in his face as he... That's still not enough. Probably will be if he can get another... Ooh, there's the nair. Just... And catches him with the back air. Ant going, trying to recover high. Might not have had much choice get that, given the mana. That is definitely going to be the stock. That's snooze for you. You think it's scary enough to have to deal with the shield breaks, but snooze is also a threat that's giving him an easy way to land a smash attack. Accelerado. A very even game right now. It can go either way, but Kofu cannot afford to lose this game if he wants to stay in this match. Yeah. missing by a hair. Trying to go for the upbeat cheese or abandoned it. Barely avoiding that fire kick. That would have been the it easily. That one's not quite going to do it, but going to put him in a very bad spot. Speaking of very bad spots, and there we go. Up smash on the landing for the game. Kofu now with one on the board. We'll see if he can make the reverse 3-0 comeback or not. Yoshi's Story. I guess that's a bit of a comfort pick for Ant, just because Hero has some wild KO power, and this is a good stage to abuse that on. Starting out in Kofu's favor, it's gonna change pretty quickly. Tried to go for a really hard punish there, and was just a tiny bit too slow. Go. They're gonna put him off stage, trying to call out the high recovery, and that's gonna put him in a bad spot. Ooh, Uppies at the right time to get some damage and safety back to stage. Great spot dodge from Kofu, going for the down smash for the guaranteed punish. Looks like he let a spell off the wrong way. Oh boy, there we go. When you have the close blast zones, you aren't the only one who can abuse them. And that up B is definitely a good example. There we go. Nice confirm off of that up B. Always use the stage to your advantage when you can, people. And there are many interesting ways to do that when it comes to ledges. Yeah, you can't really beat out that side B. It's not a projectile for some reason. It doesn't make any sense why. Ooh, and that was a devastating down B. Yep, it can get a meteor hitbox if you get it right at the top. And when you do, that you can get stuff like that. That's going to put Kofu in a very good position to take this game. And save, going to eat that F-tilt punish. Yeah, good punish, good pressure. Up-tilt, psych up, not enough. That's a big sizzle. Has another psych up, so if he can crackle slash, trying to go for the neutral B confirm and misses it. Yeah, this is definitely Kofu's game to lose right now. Just needs one more good hit to close it out. Okay, there's the stock gap closed. That's a bad trade. Almost out of mana, can't afford to be getting sent off stage in the near future, and that's gonna do it. Even games, it all comes down to that all-important Game 5. Smashville for this last stage pick. Okay, I guess he recognized that that stage was doing him as much harm as it was doing good, so might be a good idea to go somewhere else. There's a lot... Well, that down B is a lot less of a threat on this stage given that platform. Oof, just barely missing the confirm off of that neutral B. Okay, you will, that's the trick, smart thing about Hero. You gotta know when to cancel that menu. They give you a lot of ways to do it. Just barely missing that. Good catch on the roll. Now has that the oomph. So any good hit should be taking it here if you can just find one in time. I'm not sure if Kofu's going to give him the chance now. Ooh, what a dunk! Catching his recovery to snuff out both the psych up and the oomph. That was huge. Sugo went for the whack, found its mark, but not the stock. Yep, it's pretty high chance at that percent, but it's still not guaranteed. There, that, however, is definitely guaranteed at that percent. Okay, good. Oh boy, there we go. Big and another follow-up cat. That's going to put him in a really awkward spot, forced to use a lot of mana on that recovery. Again, using the neutral B to recover and finding another big bunch of damage. Even percents, even stocks, it's very close right now. And not taking his time here, trying not to fall into Kofu's traps. Interesting use of the zoom. Back air, gonna swat him back away. There we go, nice fair, gonna put him off stage. What's gonna be the follow-up? Just trying to do his signature fair pressure, not quite able to work it out. Another zoom, it's a very tense situation. And just playing it very slowly, and Kofu is recognizing that and punishing every opportunity he gets. It's not... his slow play here is not working out. That's unfortunate. That forward smash probably should have been the stock. That is not gonna quite gonna do it. Psych up. Yeah, that is such a scary move to deal with at the ledge, because if you mistime it one tiny bit, you're gonna die. It is like the ultimate checkmate in the right situation, and that's what makes it such a scary move to when they find the right opportunity to throw it out. Trying to go for the thwack cheese to steal, literally steal the game. I can respect it, but did not find it hit, so even if it was that one in a hundred chance, it wasn't gonna work anyways. And smart stuff, going for the going off stage to snuff him out, which was also an extremely high risk decision. If that had not worked, he would have thrown away that match right then and there. But he recognized that he didn't really have any other choice but to recover that way. So well done by Kofu, the reverse 3-0 to keep himself in winner's side. We'll be advancing into winner's finals now. Next up, we have Ulla and Meeks. And I think it's theoretically possible for Meeks to beat Ulla's K-Rule, but more likely than not, the odds of this match is going to depend on how seriously Ulla is taking it. Not sure what Ola's doing here. Looks like he's still getting ready to go. Yeah, Okay, not playing any wacky games today. He is in it to win it, breaking out the K rule to start. So, Nyx is off to a pretty good start, though. That's usually how this goes. The question is, can he keep up the momentum, or is Oa just going to start finding all those brutal reads to... There's a start! Every reflect hurts in this matchup. Okay, there is a nice up air confirm, going to put him off stage, but... Always gotta respect that Nair. It's invincibility. Its belly armor is quite something. Going for the edge guard, not quite enough to close it out. Oof, catches him with that, and Miss Tech is gonna be the first stock of this game. Up smash, not quite enough to finish out the crocodile. He is ahead. Ooh! Oh no! The up air putting him in the sight of that shard shot, costing him his first stock. Yep, that momentum on the up air can be helpful, but it can also hurt, and that there it backfired spectacularly. There we go, putting him off stage. Oof, what a read, but missed the chance to confirm off it. There's one of his signature tricks, the down smash out of nowhere, just barely missing its mark. And there we go, a well-timed dash attack to close out that first stock. Trying to edgeguard, interesting decision from Nyx to try and edgeguard instead of ledge trap, because usually it's the ledge trapping that excels for the Samus. Just barely missing that forward smash. Unfortunate for him. There's a good back air. Gonna put him on the back foot. Trying to do the down tilt. Yeah, that thing has a nightmarishly strong... not nightmarish, but pretty strong. But very strong Burry. And the cannonball finding its mark to close out game one with two stocks to spare. Finding first blood this game. Didn't quite guess on not crossing up. Big combo. Well, not big. Well, I guess that's a decent combo. Starting out strong again. The trend is that he gets off to a good start, and then Oa finds tons of hard reads to close out the gap and slowly take that lead. There's one. And there's another. Forward air at the ledge. Gonna take that first stock and commanding fast. Well, not commanding. It's not far from over. And it'll depend on what he finds for the... Oof. Nice pit. What a parry. Gonna put him... in the air and up air, putting him high above the stage. Ooh, not quite able to convert, but it still finds the cannonball. Claps him off stage. And was getting a little too confident in that read, and Nyx making him pay for that overconfidence. Just really making it clear that he is not afraid to, but it can only get him so far, cost him the stock, and his in his determination to end it. Okay, there we go. That's a better use of the reflect. What a call out. That is a special skip level of being able to get the read. Yikes. Great spot dodge, just barely holding on to the stock there. And not going to be holding on to it from that one. There we go, the classic forward throw into dash attack for a guaranteed 30%. Great get-up attack to force back that blunderbuss. Good use of the suck. That is not quite going to do it, but close. Just going for a lot of the craziest reads. Just wants to end it here, and Meeks is not going to let him do it. Never mind. Finds an up air anyways. That was some wild smash attack spam sequence, though. He was really confident that at least one of those was going to find its mark, and none of them did, but it didn't matter. Starting out strong, pulling out the dark suits too. Meeks means business. Then again, does he ever not? Problem is that it doesn't matter how much business you mean, Ella is just a terrifying player to be up against. Great avoidance on that charge shot reflect. Ooh, eats it and still converts into the up air. I don't think that was quite the true combo, but if it works, it works. Audi went for the grab there. There's a nice grab. Yeah, you have to be careful that armor can allow him to just nope so many attacks. And there's another good use of that reflect. He's been finding no shortage of those in this match. Rolls right into that one. Good dash attack and a put meets off stage yet again. Gets clipped by that last hit to force him off stage and get the reset to neutral. Okay, there's a clever rawr back air. Not sure if it's gonna matter, because Yep finds one of his favorite traps, the down throw into up smash. What a use of that nair to just armor through the charge shot. Dang. Yeah, sometimes you don't have to go for the crazy reads, just go for the safe ones. The ones that cover multiple things, but at the same time, he is dangerously low on that belly armor right now. Looks like he's get... Okay, and that should be the stock. Unfortunate, messed up the up smash, and in the process, the stock, the easy stock. It's very unfortunate. Oa should be on his last stock already, but Meeks just did not capitalize on the belly armor break quite as well as he should have. So has him on his last stock here. We'll see if he can at least take a game, but it's going to be a tall order with this deficit. Go. Nice up tilt, gonna put him off stage. Ooh, wow. Almost getting sent to the blast zone off of the power of that back air. once again, this the Oa crowd coming out tonight. That is going to do it. Admirable effort in that last game. Just was not able to take any of them. That's Oa for you. Just a good sign of just how far above most of the other players he is. That should mean the next match on stream is him versus Kofu. Oh, I forgot to turn on it, so... Yep. Greed has been picking up the Olimar. Which is an interesting one. A very different kind of character. Very small. A glass cannon archetype has all those Pikmin can deal out a lot of damage, especially with throwing them at the opponent, but is also also one of the shortest characters in the game, which can make it very frustrating to hit him. He got nerfed for that reason, but still is not to be underestimated. Ooh, nice confirm, not quite able to take the stock. Samus up air is not exactly a kill move. Just playing it slow, though I think this is also kind of an awkward matchup for Samus, just because there's so many opportunities to absorb those charge shots, so it's a lot harder to find them in this matchup. Meeks is the first one to find a stock this game, so that's a pretty good sign for his chances here. Yep, up throw with the blue Pikmin is 100% going to do it at that percent. Do note that it's only with the blue Pikmin that up throw becomes really strong. Oof, catches him stalling on the ledge with that up tilt. It's part of why it's why Samus's ledge trapping game is so strong, because it covers so much, including that. You have to pick every option against Samus optimally, or you'll just be sent back into that vortex of pain. And looks like the okay, not quite dead, but not gonna be living for much longer at this rate. No trade is a good trade at these percents. Back air, still not enough, but the charge shot is definitely enough. Game one, pretty convincingly taken by Meeks. We'll see if Greed sticks with the Olimar or goes back to the Incineroar. Yep, Incineroar it is. Going with his signature Froggy tag. There's a decent revenge, but still gets put off stage. We'll see. Oh boy! Trying to really go for some cheesy stuff and gets a lot of damage out of that one. Good punish on that side B with the down air. Forward air, putting him off stage. Ooh, and there's a very hard punish on the stage landing for first stock. Interesting, I think he was expecting him to run up and instead did the F tilt. Trying to go for a forward smash. Oh, that's an interesting attempt at punish. Gets grab punished because that move is so unsafe. Very well timed side B. Not enough from that far into the stage. Good avoidance at least. Did not find a hit. Nice back air. It's going to be the follow up. Trying to guess for a fast recovery, but instead just stalls it out. That's what. So, what can be good about those tether recoveries is the flexibility of the timing. Usually, they'll try and recover to stage, which you can catch if they with a read. But sometimes they can just wait, and there we go, up B for the first stock. Should have found the words easier than I did. Ooh, just barely missing, and eats a charge shot for his troubles. Ooh, and catches him with that up tilt, because, yeah, that move is very vulnerable during that downward arc. If you can time a move against it, you can very easily interrupt it. Big damage, not going to be sending him all the way to the blast zone, unfortunately for Greed. Still, big 50%, ooh, letting that charge shot loose a bit too early. Trying anything to close the stock gap. Ooh! Almost took the stock with that. Just not quite enough. Yeah, that feels like it should have been the stock, but it just wasn't. And snipes him out of the air for the game two. Meeks already on match point. Oh, also... Sticking with the ensign, it's all down to this. Well, if Meeks takes this, then the match is over and he continues on. Ooh, there's an interesting down air. Yeah, that neutral B covers a lot just because it's so active. Not quite going to be taking the stock on the side of the stage. Not at a high enough percent. But that is the absolute worst place to get grabbed by that thing because it is strong. Great edge guarding from Greed to close out the stock very early. Meek's getting his revenge very quickly, it would seem. Ooh, there's a nice back air to force him back. Covering high to avoid that charge shot. Phantom Footstool, you make the call. Good wait to avoid the revenge. Another good charge shot, putting him off stage. Unfortunately timed air dodge is going to prevent him from grabbing that ledge. Ooh, that's going to hurt. Not going to be taking a stock, though. Once again, catching him get over eager and just barely missing that down air. Ooh, did not miss that. Once again, putting Meeks off stage. Dash attack, just smacking him and going for that off stage edge guard to take it first again. Trying to parry it, not quite able to find its mark. Wow, what a well-timed charge shot there. Good get up, because, yeah, you do not want to get caught without invincibility on the ledge against that up tilt. Just getting smacked off over and over and over. Here we go. Up air. Ooh, was ready for it, but just did not quite get the punish. Either player's game right now. Favoring Greed at the moment. If he can just find the finishing blow, then it'll be over in a moment. Oh boy! And just like that, one big combo closing that gap almost entirely, and now has the percentage lead. That's why I said it was either player's game, folks. Just, oh no! Okay, good match, because that is not a good place to be caught against Incineroar in a grab. That much rage and that much percent, it very easily could have been the game. Yep, got a little too greedy with that high recovery and costs him the game. ...3-0 sweep from Meeks. And are they still playing? Dang! Looks like we're going to be waiting a while for the next Meeks set. Probably should send Oa and Kofu on stream if they aren't currently playing. Okay, looks... they're good. Okay, Kofu and Oa on deck. Going for the Mii Brawler again. Maybe he's in the mood to grind the Brawler. Here we go. Winners finals is on the stream. We will see if Oa can take it or if Kofu's Mighty Mii Brawler will do the trick. That was an interesting reflect. Gonna be put off stage and expecting the recovery, because yeah, that thing can get some real cheese. That's why he prefers it to use that over the more notorious Thrupper. Which Thrupper is probably still the better option if you're playing Mii Brawler. Still, play what you want to play at the end of the day. Just barely avoiding that. Oop, not quite enough. Up tilt, not quite finishing out the job. Ooh, nice choice of get up option. Kofu was definitely not ready for that one. Oh, I wasn't any more ready for that, and that is absolutely going to be the stock. Not even a question. You do not want to get caught by that grab on the side of the stage. Very well-timed grab to avoid that damage from the crown. You do not want that thing to land when Oa can very easily convert it into a combo. There we go. Finds the suck to put him back off stage. Just barely not able to get that forward smash punish. And there's a well-timed fair to close out the second stock. Answering back with an up smash, still full stock behind, is an extremely daunting deficit to be facing against this killer crocodile. This diabolical... Okay, that didn't quite work. The Crazy King. And at this rate, it's not going to be over before too terribly long. Ooh, there's a big meteor hit. Kind of. Oof! What a confirm, taking that first game with two stocks to spare. Oh, a crew. His dominance for the start, showing why he's the top of the food chain around here. Can do differently here. Interesting he didn't go for the dash attack, just wanting to, instead opting for the crown pressure. Good read on the not cross up, getting the guaranteed grab.
Okay. Oh boy. Oof.
Always got to be ready for those meteor smash shenanigans because they lead so well into the up air and up smash. Ooh, interesting choice to use the up air to land on the stage. Very well-timed grab, keeping them off stage and not fall into any crown shenanigans. Fell to that. Interesting. Just was looking for some kind of interesting read running on his shield, and instead of going for a grab, I went for a roll. Good pressure. Just barely missing the Nair follow-up off of that crown. Oof, missing that grab by a hair. Game was looking pretty good for Kofu right now. Can't be too confident against Oa, though. He loves his cheesy kills. He's very, very good at finding them. Yep, Kofu really doing his best, keeping the pressure up, not allowing Oa one chance to breathe. Eats the back air, so gets the reset to neutral and dash attack, catching the high recovery for the first, for the second stock, so Oa still has a chance in this game, which is not a good thing for Kofu. There's a good punish on his forward air shenanigans. Well, once again, Oa recognizing his running on his shield and going for a grab. That's the tricky thing. You do it for too long, the opponent can be ready. Oh boy! This game is rapidly falling away from Kofu. If he gives him another chance, that's going to be a really bad one. Good. Oh no! Ate the fire kick and in the process ate his stock too. Oof. I'm not sure if he probably could have recovered from that situation, though. It would have been close. Unfortunately, we don't know for sure if that was an intentional eating of it to throw off his recovery. Big brain. Just big brain moves from Oa coming out tonight. Ironic for playing a crocodile like K. Rool, but still. Starting out with the grab to put him off stage. This game is looking very good for Oa right now. Not gonna fall to the down smash this time. Maybe next time, but not this one. Just really trying to plank him on the side of the stage. Starting to make some stuff happen. Yep, that Nair is so safe. You kind of, sometimes you just gotta accept that you're gonna have to shield a jab. It's frustrating, but it's just too safe to do much else. Dash attack, not quite enough. Landing on stage against K. Rool, a bold decision to say the least. Great grab fault on recognizing the low percent that would guarantee that follow-up. Oh, that's really bad for Kofu. It is going to be a Christmas miracle if he takes it back. Okay, I apologize for making like Walmart and referencing Christmas in August. There we go. At least one stock off. Yep, very unsafe. And there we go. Just going for the dunk to close it out. Ending his 3 in this match. We'll see if he can get the run back in Grand Finals, or if it will be someone else. Most likely Meeks, but we don't know. Well, I guess Ant's still in it too, so that it's kind of a toss-up between those two. Avery's been leveling up, though, so it's not entirely impossible. It's unlikely, but not impossible. We're going to be waiting quite a while before that gets going, because Sunny T and Avery are still playing. Sunny T. Okay, we are indeed getting underway. Sunny T taking his seat. Where is Ant? Looks like we're going to be waiting a bit more, so. Yep. Looks like we're finally getting underway with Where are we? Thought Ant was coming to play his match. Okay. Okay, after 1,000 years, we are finally ready to go with the next match, I think. And we are, and never mind. Close, but no cigar. Okay, now we can get this show on the road. Not sure what to say that I haven't said before. This is a dreadful matchup for Duck Hunt. And even without that, I'm pretty confident saying that Ant is the better player. So, best of luck to you with Sunny T, but we'll have to see how it pans out. By all means, make me eat my words. And let's get, here we go. Oh, just watching from behind, or not really, but because he just wants us to be ready when his time comes. What? We finally get the show on the road, and then we have a controller issue. I am beginning to wonder if this match is cursed. Oh boy. It's not me. Yeah, that doesn't happen very often, so Yeah, that's weird. Okay, getting back to what was going on. Well, looks like whatever they decided on, it gave Sunny T a good chance to get some damage in. But this is where the problems start. That bounce just completely wrecks a lot of the ability for Duck Hunt to even play. Also, that doesn't help either. It has a very hard to keep Hero out when he's when he can go across the stage in one jump, and that was a good forward smash, to his credit, though. Taking a stock at 100% is always a good thing to be doing as Duck Hunt, because that does not happen very often. Ooh! Going for the dunk! Respect it. He's just trying to find every early way, finding another up smash, not at a percent where it's going to kill, though. That's going to hurt. Good tech, though. Oof. Oh boy. Just barely missing the back air confirm. There we go. Up tilt to finally close out the stock. Sunny T might actually take this game if he can just keep it up. There's a good shield. Oh boy, there's where it becomes scary. Oh no! Why? Oh no! That is gonna do a number on his chances of winning this game. Celerano. Trying to keep his distance as much as possible. Needs to make every hit count. Can't afford to do anything less. Oh, this is tense. This is his chance to take a game. He can just find the closing hit before Ant does. Unfortunately, he's going to have to work for that closing hit a lot harder than Ant, just by the nature of the characters. Ooh, psych up. That could do some damage. There we go. He's running into everything, and there we go! Taking a game! We'll see if that's the only one, but still, taking even one game is a huge accomplishment. Unfortunately, I'm going to be very surprised if he takes another. I'm not trying to be mean, I just know that it's how bad of a matchup it is and this skill gap that it's Sunny T is the ultimate underdog in this one, no pun intended. If I'm wrong, I will gladly admit so. There's just so much working against Duck Hunt in this matchup. Yep, and there we go. Tried to guess when it would end there and backfired in his face. There we go. Nice start. Oof. Up tilt. Not quite enough. I guess he was expecting him to fall the stage faster. There we go, another reflect. The worst thing to be seeing against Hero in this matchup. And there we go, turning that up B into the dunk to close out that first stock. Great read from Sunny T, though. Lucky, running right into that can. Oh boy. Trying to go for the down air, but a well-timed air dodge will keep him alive. Celerado, there's a scary one to see. Oof, and a double fair to close out the second stock. That's what's that's the most scary thing about the move. Since the mobility is so much higher, you can get that combo. A combo that would normally not be possible for a character suddenly becomes very possible. You know, this game is all but over for Sunny T. Unless he pulls a miraculous comeback. There's a big bunch of damage from the Kaboom. Back air, just what is it gonna take? Yep, using a lot of mana, then doesn't quite pan out. Oof, reading the menu for a little too long. One. After that impressive first game, that definitely feels more like what to expect out of this matchup. Devastating reflects and fair, that double fair combo, one of the nastiest combos in Heroes Arsenal. Going to the Isabelle. Looks like. Granted, probably a less dreadful matchup. But I don't think it's a good one, though. So, to start, it's pretty even. Oof. Yeah, that fishing rod, it can only get you so far. And there's a big reflect. That's still a problem in this matchup. It means that Isabelle is forced to scrap and does not have great options to do that. Yep, it's... The good news is that recovery is incredibly good, so it's not very easy to catch him in a guaranteed edge guard. There's a nice up tilt in the up air combo, at least. One for the down throw variant of the fishing rod. Oof, there's a big bunch of damage off of the Psycup. Ooh, running right in to get in that hit. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Not gonna be the stock closer. Yeah, I'm not sure if it's even worth going for in this matchup, but that's always worth going for. That's going to be closing out the stock on its own. Fortunately, it now has the bounce. Okay, what happened there? Well, took the stock. That's what's important. Finding the accelerado. And now going to be doing those shenanigans. Doesn't follow him off stage, try and go for the edge guard. I guess felt that would have been a little too obvious. Good read on the air dodge. Trying to get some air guarding shenanigans. Ooh, does catch him that time at least. And there we go. All three stocks, the neutral bead doing the job. It's, what can I say? It's a strong move. It takes a lot of mana. It's still something you always need to be having on your mind. could pocket it if he can get a really good read. That would be very scary for Hero to be dealing with. Going back to the duck hunt. Okay, there's a big side B. 25%, yeesh, that thing is strong. Got the side B. Wasn't able to capitalize it. Can't really do that from across stage as Duck Hunt. Just kind of an... Well, I guess that's the case for most projectiles. Only a select few can really turn them into outright projectile combos. Duck Hunt can in the right situation, but it requires a lot of setup. There's a good read. Yeah, he needs to find every panic option and punish it to the fullest extent to take in anything too special in this one. Ooh, I thought he escaped, but nope. So, it's the scariest move in Hero's arsenal. Up smash, not enough. I also find it interesting how Ant never ever uses Magic Burst. Guess maybe it's a Hero thing that they realize it's too high risk of a move to be going for regularly. Because it does take all your mana. It's the epitome of high risk, high reward. So maybe the risk is just too high. Also, I just noticed that he's already on his last stock. Oof. That can I save it? Oof. Okay, looks like Sunny T just accepted his fate and gave the game and match to Ant. I apologize if I contributed to that. Still, it's a rough matchup. There's really not much more to say. It's like now you're finally going to be having Ant versus Meeks up. Whenever he's ready, at least. Oh yeah, Kofu's waiting in Loser's Finals. Okay, looks like Ant's playing a match in Melee, so we're going to be waiting a bit. Just so we're clear, nothing's really going on right now. It's just Oa going into training to take. So I guess he really wants to be good at DK. So yeah, nothing too much to see here, folks. But it's better than nothing, so why not? Be sure to watch very closely in case you go up against his DK.
Three, two, one, go! top battle, Donkey Kong.
Okay, that's enough of the friendlies, because we've got another match to run for the third place and a guaranteed payout. Ant versus Meeks. Not the first time we've seen these two face off. I think it's slightly more in favor of Ant. We could see.
Mm-hmm.
Now on to the match. Looks like they're just going for tech skills right now. Just making sure they both got their tech stuff underway, respecting each other's to make sure that they're both playing on point. I don't think I've seen them do this before. Interesting. Are they gonna SD and then get to a proper match after this? Interesting, it's been a while since I've seen people do this on stream. Okay, looks like we're getting this show on the road. Or not. Now we're going to the SD race. Where Meeks is just taking a bit more time to get tech skill as Ant SDs, so... Well, with that out of the way, let's see if we'll get an extra technical match on stream. Finding the first damage of the game and then a double up air to follow it up, but just one side B, it does more damage than all of that. Powerful move, and that costs mana for a reason. Okay, good spacing around it, at least. Some very close near misses. Ooh, and there's something you never want to get hit by. Ooh, first talk of the game being taken by Ant. Oh no, falling out. That's the awkward thing about that up smash. And is why you don't see Samus players going for it too often. It's just not reliable enough. Going for the weak hit. Weak neutral B. It's a charge shot. Each one version has its own use. There's a big read from Meeks to close out the first stock. Just eating big shots for the menus. Not able to convert that nair into a combo, but finding one right as he lands. I don't know if he meant to do that on stage or not. Ooh, barely stuffing that out in time, and ooh, rare SD from Ant. That SD could easily cost him this game. Good roll to get away from that nightmare of a move. Very well timed roll. The down air combos with Samus are real, people. They are very real.
just using for the weak up D for the simple out of shield, which is the main thing it's good for. It's just get them off me button, but it's still kind of high risk considering the reward. Oof! Nearly taking the stock there, but not quite. Trying to go for the edge guard, makes the thing just out of range. Samus is not an easy character to edge guard, which is why you generally don't see people go for it too much. Ooh, there we go. Neutral B for the first stop, the first game. Going to game two, we'll see what changes. Oh, looks like I've got them lined up with the wrong side, so let's go ahead and fix that. There we go. Whew, and parry of the charge shot. That was a pretty big crackle slash, and there's a kaboom. 30%, yikes! I think he was looking for a back air there, and Meeks recognized the situation to turn it around. That back air is slow, people. It's 18 frames, one of the slowest back airs in the game. There's a nice conversion off of the down B. And there we go, another well-timed down B into up tilt to close out that first stock. I'm not sure what he could have done differently there. It's when you get stuck in those situations as hero, you run out of options to mix it up except for zoom, and that's not guaranteed. Nearly taking the stock there. Ooh, that should have been the stock, but he just missed the chance to close it out. Okay, finding an up tilt. Didn't make too much of a difference in the end. What a conversion. People are recognizing Ant's air dodge habits and making him pay. Speaking of being made to pay, eats that kaboom for the second stock. So this game isn't over yet. Try to catch a good pressing buttons, just maximizing the pressure. Interesting. I feel like he was looking for a back air, but he decided to do up air when he realized that he wasn't going to fall to it that easily. Okay, nice snipe to do some more damage. Okay, catches him air dodging and finishes it out with the up tilt. Meeks now on match point. Oh boy, Ant's gonna need to take the next three games to take this match. A daunting task indeed. Missing the confirm, but still, okay, getting the back-to-back side beefs for a nice 40%. Oof, what a confirm! That was savage! Getting the perfectly timed reflect and then converting it into the side B? I have never seen that one before. I feel like that alone turned this game's momentum on its head. And now in a pretty good position. Running a jab to just tack on the damage and build up the percentage lead. Then sucked into the up B for a bit more damage. It's gonna have to finish it. The stock eventually. Missing the chance to neutral B and finds an air, so it doesn't made our. Ooh, great snipes, just catching him looking for the menu. You gotta know when to order off that thing, because otherwise they'll be the one cooking you. Oof, there we go. Great charge shot into forward smash to close out that second stock. Feels like it's rapidly slipping away from Ant. Trying to go for some up air shenanigans. Was ready for it. Gets a fair air punish at least. Great punish on that. Let's get up. Still dying to the very corner of the screen. An admirable attempt, but it's just too strong at that percent. It's gonna take a lot for Ant to take this game from here. It could be done. You could have gone for a forward air follow-up. Not gonna fall to the neutral B this time. Maybe next time. Ooh, and that's gonna do it. Once again, ordering at the wrong time and being delivered his demise. And with that, Meeks will be continuing on to Losers Finals to face off against Kofu.
Yeah.
Bad. There we go. And now for who gets the second place payouts versus the third place payout. A difference that's about all of $10. Wait, what? Okay, I don't think we're seeing any Belmonts from Meeks, as funny as that would be. Tofu pulling out the knee brawler. We'll see if he can take on handle Meeks or not. Not starting out too great for Tofu here. Yeah, you can't. You can only pressure Samus so much with that really good out of shield up B. Ideally, you want to punish it as hard as possible every time Meeks does go for it, because that is just an escape option a lot of the time. Ooh, and there we go. Good dash attack punish on that down B. Trying to just cheese him with the down air, interesting choice. Yep, you can't pressure Samus easily. And there we go, that's what he was looking for earlier. Still at a deficit. A pretty sizable one. Still going for the up B recoveries. Yeah, just does a lot. We're hoping to find that rare cheese situation where they just lose a random stock at like 40. Now that could have been a lot deadlier of an up air combo if he had had Thrupper. Eats the charge shot for that down B. Okay, was just able to punish that in time. Hoping for a get up jump. Woo! Dang! Just running up and punishing him point blank for trying to go for the up smash. Eating a down smash punish for that one. Back air will do it. And answering back, it's a tense last stock situation now for both players. Getting the meteor hit, it only does 8%, dang. I guess that I didn't want to make it too strong since it is already a meteor smash, and those are scary enough as it is. Ooh, interesting that he went for the slow mix-up. Okay, yeah, that nair is so active.
great getup. Great choice of getup. Yeah, you don't want to be getting hit by a down B at this percent. But just run up of an up smash for the game. On to game two. It really felt like it should have been Meeks' game, but he just let it slip away. Let's see if he can keep this one in firm, more firm grasp. Also, this would definitely be a lot sketchier pick against the Brawler if he was using the Thrupper. I might say that a lot. It's just difficult to overemphasize just how strong that move is. Not a great recovery, but it is nightmarishly strong at finishing stocks. Great time to do it, because yeah, that's what's so scary about that move, is that if you use it at the right time, it's a great checkmate option, just saying, hey, I know what you're going to do, and you're going to pay for doing it. And if it's an edge guard, you're gonna die. What is Meeks looking for? Finally gets a punish on that down B at least, so making something happen, taking the nick. Get in the Nair to close out the first stock, so it's a start. There we go, catching the high jump. Phew, that could have been a more interesting combo if that back air had converted. Yep, high risk, high reward. And there. That was the risk. It's very punishable, like especially against a character like Samus, who has that tether grab. Ooh, and there we go. One of his favorite combos. Very good at landing the sweet spot most of the time. There we go. Down smash, just trying to take stage control. Generally a pretty good idea, and great call out on that down beat. It got a little too eager with that down smash, and Kofu was very ready for it with the down smash punish. Still, Meeks is in a pretty good position. Just don't let him... boy, I might have commentators cursed it. Oh, great snipe out of the air. It's only gets you so far, folks. And that might just do it. No. Yeah, just catching Kofu pressing buttons, taking that second game.
Three, two, one.
on to game three, going to small battlefield, so no, a lot less room for ladder shenanigans for Samus. Once again, sniping him with the charge shot. Interesting that he didn't go for the kick. That might have been a situation where it actually would have been better, because I don't think Meeks would have been ready for it. Ooh, nice punish on that down smash. Just jumping at the right moment and being well spaced to ensure that it would close it out. Getting the fire kick, trying to get another to close it out. Ooh, oh, never mind. I thought he would missed his chance to recover, but not quite. Ooh, there we go. A bit of a suboptimal conversion, but a conversion nonetheless. Okay, finding the stock with a well-timed rapid-fire neutral B. It's a start. Yeah, needs to really make every hit count right now when he's at this much of a deficit. Okay, good recognition on that spot dodge and punishing it. How did he shield that? How? Doesn't have like at least one frame of vulnerability. That made no sense. Well, that does. Yeah, you can't always rely on getting those fire kicks against Samus, because that down B is a great air stall. There's a nice grab punish. Got up, so not going to be being sent to the blast zone with that down air. Yep, you have to be doing it preemptively to get a punish on that up B. It has so little end lag. There we go. That's a nice use of the down B. Good patience to wait out the missile. Mashed for too long, costing him some damage on the throw. Not going to get the forward smash confirmed this time, at least. Leading an up smash for the second stock. Ooh, and there we go. I was about to say it's Meek's game to lose, but he's not even getting to give me the chance to say it. Just solidifying, this is my game. And with that, he is now on match point to continue on to grand finals. Kofu started out strong. It's starting to get back control a bit. I'm not sure what he was looking for, but he dropped his chance to get the roll punish. It was like Meeks intended something and then decided, nah, I'll do something else, and you can't really second guess yourself too much in these situations. It's too tense of a situation. Nice spot dodge to avoid that one. Well, he's putting that down beat a better use this game. Oh boy! Yeah, just getting kicked in the face. Dive kicked in the face, I should say. Yeah, no, it doesn't really have a kill throw. Probably for the best. Not safe. Not safe at all. Still alive. And somehow Meeks takes the first stock. Full rage definitely is part of the reason why. Finds a way to finally close it out with a well-timed down smash. Oh boy. Another well timed place to down B. Got a little too greedy, and well, fortunately, Meeks didn't get the sweet spot on the forward smash, so not going to be losing the stock quite yet. Catches him with the. What? This is game four. Meeks is. Is up. There's a nice grab. What was he trying to do with that nair? Going off stage with it is definitely a choice. Lose your patience, and the zoner will make you pay. There we go. Great back air to close out the second stock. He has a fighting chance. He's going to have to play it very well. There's a good use of the down B to stay out of the way of the charge shots. And that's not good. Really not good. Nice conversion. Oh boy, I threw myself off stage and now has to deal with... Okay, interesting you didn't try and capitalize on that down B. There's a nice conversion. Doesn't quite get the forward smash. And there we go. Catches him waiting on the ledge with that up tilt. And with that, Meeks is continuing on to grand finals. I'm just tired.
Oh boy, Oa making a statement. He is going to dunk. He is determined to dunk Meeks with the Donkey Kong. That is, I don't think that worked out too well from last week. So, then again, he did just win a LOL $69 yesterday at ESA. So, what's the rough? What's the need to be serious?
I thought so too. No, I don't even. Yeah.
Interesting attempt at going for the grab there. Now that Donkey Kong is not worth looking too hot. What a mash. Doesn't quite get the timing right. Not sure if it's true or not, but maybe. My guess is that it is, and Oa just isn't able to time it properly because he isn't quite the DK main he would have you believe. Well, because he isn't a DK main, but that's besides the point. Just trying his best, but went too low to up B back to the ledge. Was expecting it to cross up, and it did not. What's it gonna take to close out this stock? There's some more damage to tack on, at least. There we go. Back option off of the cargo throw will do the trick.
Thank you.
Not still pretty far behind it right now. So it's a big body that makes it a lot easier to land those charge shots. Trying to land the charge punch of his own. Interesting he didn't go for the up throw. I guess he wants to make sure that he only uses it once it's truly viable. There we go. That is absolutely going to be the stock. It's not a good move. It's not a great move by any means, but it's still a kill move at the end of the day. So if you can get the right read, it'll still hurt. There are very few moves in this game that are genuinely useless. And I wouldn't quite say DK's up B is one of them. There we go, the ding-dong for some damage. Oh no! That was a combo, alright. Still able to get back to stage at least. Gonna get smacked back by a well-timed Nair. Smacked again by a down B into up neutral B. And that is going to do it. Just getting ledge trapped into oblivion, as Samus does sometimes. I expect that. Oh, he's probably gonna stick with DK, and he does that. Frequently in this mode where he just wants to go all out with that secondary, and indeed he does. Given that he has another set to potentially, he's definitely in a position where he has a lot of room to adjust or decide on K-Rule if he needs to in the next set. Interesting that he went to challenge Meeks on his own favorite stage. Yep, not able to recover. Samus' recovery is good, but it's not unlimited. Phew, that was an interesting clink. Catching him jumping with the down air to force him back to the bottom. Oof, a very bad miss input. Gonna cost him that first stock. Okay, that was a pretty good use of the fair, covering that entire platform. Using the up B to mix up the landing. Ooh, there we go! Down air into up air for that first stock. It's not as... And there we go, the weird launch hit from the up B, the hitbox that would get you some obscenely early stocks in Smash 4 with its infamously broken rage. Yeah, just going for the grab punish there. I guess he knew that a forward smash wasn't going to be doing anything too special. I feel like he should have gone for the forward smash punish on that one, though. That could have easily been the stock. There we go. Edge guard for the game. Thank you. On to game three, 1-1. Not able to get anything too special. Yeah, that back air is really good, people. I've talked trash about DK, but the one thing, one of the big things that is unironically amazing is that back air. Great range, great frame data. You have to respect it. And put that nair to pretty good use. I wouldn't say it's a great move, but it has its uses. Main problem is just kind of on the slow side, but it still is a decently ranged and has potential for follow-ups, like many other similar nairs. Oof. That funny monkey doing funny monkey things. Not gonna get another charge punch quite so soon. Very optimal punish from me, because I don't know why Oa didn't bother to move forward with it. He's getting a little too upbe happy, and it's coming back to bite him. Masterful mash from Meeks, not going to give him the chance to escort him to the blast zone. Oh, nice punish on the grab. Interesting attempt at the side B, but just did not have enough armor. Multi-hits be like that. Awkward! Another neutral B for big damage, at least. Ooh, catching him ledge stalling. Yeah. Which that up tilt does so well. Yep, go for the air dodge, and it's pretty easy to just go for another up air. That dash attack out of against the side B Burry. But a simple grab punish, doesn't get the chance. Not able to convert that down air into the up air for the game. Yeah, he's way too overeager to try and finish it out with the upbees. Not quite able to close that out just yet with the back throw. Still not enough. Staling definitely not helping. Another attempt, but just that should do it. Still no. That's frustrating. Three more times, and it still isn't enough. Great call out from Oa. That was brilliant. Just recognizing that. Meeks is going to go for that up tilt because it's such an impressive move with these ledge trapping scenarios, and ducks beneath the stage, then goes for the forward air, recognizing that the percentage is high enough that that will kill from across the stage. Great stuff. Oa on tournament point.
On to game four. If Meeks loses this one, he's out, and Oa is the champion for tonight. Interesting clink. There we go. Frame data so good that he's able to confirm the back air into an F tilt. That's the frustrating thing about being a super heavy. A lot of moves will land extra well on you. Not able to get the up air, but is able to get the back air for the... Not able to get the forward smash follow-up once again. Well-timed. Ooh, yeah. Always way too upbeat happy. That was a pretty scary place to be caught in the down B. Nearly losing the shield to it. Yep, that forward air, it's just way too slow. I think he might have taken the wrong message from winning the last game with it. Ooh, got the meteor hitbox. That's an awkward one to see. Forward throw, just barely able to close out the stock. Trying to dunk him for... else to say. That got the cheese with the uppy and now has the stock lead. That's a really bad mistake for Meeks to have made. Still finds a down B into Nair to close out the second stock, so it's still either player's game. Still, it should be very clearly Meeks to game to lose instead of fighting for his survival in the tournament here. The Zare has so much range, you always have to respect that thing. Just playing it safe, trying to look for an option to punish. Great get up attack to force Meeks back. And gets the edge guard for the match. Showing that his DK is legit. Beating one of our best players with that Funky Monkey. Or wait, no, that's Funky Kong. Still, well, job well done by Oa. Yeah, he is once again your cash champion. Well, that will do it for tonight. Maybe I'll put Street Fighter on stream. But otherwise, see you all later.